Did you know that ancient Greeks found quartz crystals so captivating they believed they had supernatural powers? They called them kristallos, which translates to icy cold. Fast forward to today, and we're still fascinated by crystals, albeit for different reasons. Now we're delving into the world of crystal necklaces for healing and well-being. Imagine you're having a chat with a friend who's an expert in crystal healing. You ask, "What's the deal with these crystal necklaces?" Your friend, all enthusiastic, replies, "Well, it's all about energy. Crystals vibrate at their own frequency, and when worn close to the body, they can help to realign our own energies." You raise an eyebrow, intrigued, and follow up with, "And how does that promote healing?" Without missing a beat, your friend explains, "Different crystals have different properties. Some are believed to promote emotional healing, others physical healing, and some even mental clarity." Let's delve deeper into the world of crystals, beyond the spiritual and into the scientific. Some crystals, when compressed, develop electrical charges known as piezoelectricity at their ends. Others develop similar charges when heated, a phenomenon called pyroelectricity. This isn't just New Age mumbo jumbo. These properties are evident in common crystals like quartz and have practical applications in modern technology. For instance, quartz is utilized in sonar and radio for amplifying electric current. It even plays a significant role in the creation of the solar battery, which converts sunlight into electrical energy. So the next time you marvel at a crystal pendant, remember, it's not just a pretty bauble. It's a testament to nature's power, a marriage of beauty and utility. This understanding of the scientific properties of crystals not only grounds our exploration in reality, but also deepens our respect for these natural wonders. It's this blend of the mystical and the scientific that makes crystal healing such a fascinating area to explore. Your curiosity piqued. You ask, "So if I were to start exploring this, where would I begin?" Your friend smiles and starts to explain, "Start with something simple, like a clear quartz or an amethyst necklace. They're both known as master healers. But remember, it's important to cleanse and set your intention into the crystal for it to work effectively." As the conversation winds down, you find yourself fascinated by the potential benefits of crystal healing. You realize there's a lot more to explore, from the history of crystals in ancient civilizations to their uses in modern technology. And who knows, maybe one day you'll find yourself wearing a crystal necklace, not just for its aesthetic appeal, but for its healing properties too. So delve into the world of crystal healing, unearth the mysteries, debunk the myths, and discover a new perspective on well-being. Isn't it fascinating how the wisdom of the ancient Greeks can still resonate in our lives today? And who knows, maybe there's a crystal out there just waiting to harmonize with your energy. It's a captivating world, this crystal healing, and it's all there for you to explore. Crystals have been a part of human history and culture since before the time of the ancient Egyptians. Crystals played a very important role back in the ancient days of Atlantis. They have been revered for their perceived healing properties and their ability to cleanse our bodies of negative energies. This belief extends to the idea that crystals can store images and thoughts, acting as guardians of our past knowledge. Imagine a crystal as a storage device, not unlike a hard drive, containing a wealth of information waiting to be discovered. They are said to emit frequencies, store and discharge light, and can be re-energized by the sun and moon. A clear quartz crystal, for instance, is believed to be a magnet for positive energy. Have you ever heard of crystal wands? Small wands with crystals mounted at both ends are said to have the ability to locate pain or illness within the body. It's as if they have a sixth sense, guiding us towards healing and well-being. And let's not forget the legendary tales of the lost continent of Atlantis. Some mystics claim that the Atlanteans utilized crystals to harness psychic energy and establish interstellar communication. However, it is also believed that a powerful crystal energy source led to the destruction of Atlantis. Edgar Cayce, a renowned mystic of the 20th century, spoke of his visions of the great crystals that powered Atlantis. He also emphasized the healing capacities of crystals and their potential to aid in meditation, healing, and achieving higher levels of consciousness. As we journey deeper into the world of crystals, let's remember that while the science may be complex, the goal is simple: to find balance, harmony, and a deeper connection with ourselves and the universe. So let's continue our exploration. In our exploration of the multifaceted world of crystals, we've explored their historical significance, mystical uses, and healing properties. Now let's delve into a fascinating aspect that's been a part of human culture for centuries: the art of crystal gazing, or scrying. This ancient technique of divination allows seers to glimpse into the future by gazing into a clear surface, most commonly a crystal ball. Crystal balls, often made from pure quartz, have been the classic tool for scrying that was very popular in the Middle Ages. Their perfectly polished, spherical shape is believed to channel the crystal's energy in all directions equally, creating a clear and balanced field of vision for the seer. The crystal ball acts as a focus for the seer's intuitive powers and psychic energy, helping them to see visions or gain insights about future events. However, crystal gazing isn't just about predicting the future. It's also a form of meditation, a way to clear the mind, focus one's energy, and tap into the deeper levels of consciousness. The crystal ball serves as a mirror to the soul, reflecting not just the potential future, but also our innermost thoughts and feelings. Contemporary psychic readers still use crystal balls for divination, maintaining the age-old tradition alive. Some also believe that different types of crystals can offer varied insights. For instance, an amethyst ball might help in spiritual matters, while a rose quartz ball could guide one in matters of the heart. In the next scene, we'll learn more about how to choose the right crystal for you. But before we do, remember this: the power of a crystal ball, like all crystals, comes not just from the crystal itself, but also from the energy and intention you bring to it. So delve deep, gaze into the crystal, and open your mind to the wisdom it may reveal.